Magnetars are scary. In fact, astronomers will state quite unequivocally that magnetars are among the scariest objects in the galaxy. What exactly is a magnetar, and what makes it so scary? A magnetar is an exotic neutron star with exceptionally strong magnetic fields, with an emphasis on the word exceptionally. Even ultra-powerful as a descriptive attribute does not do the star justice. To enable you to better comprehend the sheer strength of a magnetar, think of a magnet so powerful that it has the ability to wipe out every credit card on Earth, from a distance halfway to the moon. The magnetic field of a magnetar is up to 1 quadrillion gauss, that is about 1,000 times stronger than a normal neutron star, and about trillion times that of the Earth's. The magnetic field of a magnetars are strong enough to ruin and wreck the environment they come in contact with. If you were to come as close as even 600 miles, or 1,000 kilometers to a magnetar, your end will be quick and deadly. The magnetic field would drive enormous bursts of high-intensity radiation and destroy your body, literally tearing away the electrons from your atoms and converting you into a cloud of monatomic ions. It will not only upset your bioelectricity and render your impulses useless, but also kill your entire molecular structure. Simply put, you would just dissolve. Other than these super powerful magnetic fields, magnetars also give out immense amounts of energy, in the form of flares, X-rays, and gamma ray bursts. They are therefore linked with extreme events in the universe, making them ill-reputed among all cosmic objects. The only objects triumphing this dubious distinction are perhaps the black holes. So how do magnetars come into existence? Stars experience a life cycle, just like everything else in the universe. But the end of the star depends entirely on the mass of the star. Most massive stars can erupt into supernovae and then become either a neutron star or a black hole. Magnetars are the remains of such stars that collapse into a neutron star after exploding in a supernova. And with their distinct magnetic field, they are truly one of the most powerful magnetic objects known to us in the universe. There are 31 confirmed magnetars as of March 2020, out of around 3,000 known neutron stars. Many of these are located in the Milky Way. But luckily, none are close enough to the Earth to cause any damage. The closest magnetar is about 9,000 light-years away, in the constellation Carina, which is also very far, a distance beyond what we have explored in our galaxy. In fact, even probes like Voyager 1 and 2 have not gone that deep into space. Magnetars are truly the weird objects of the cosmic circus, generating incomprehensible amounts of energy that can be detected across the universe. The universe still has much to reveal to us in the way of the unexpected and the outlandish. The exact cause of magnetars being so fiercely magnetic and their immense bursts of energy across the electromagnetic spectrum has yet not been deciphered. With much research going on in this field, astrophysicists believe that it could be caused by a neutron star's density and bizarre interior made of neutrons, quarks, and exotic states of matter, such as the Bose-Einstein condensates, becoming a superconducting fluid. The rotation of the star mimics a huge dynamo, generating an immense magnetic field. Others claim that it simply may have its origins in its ancestral star, with an unusually strong magnetic field. However, what is known for sure is that magnetars do not survive for long. Thank the universe for that bit of good news. After about roughly 10,000 years, they settle down to become a long-term normal neutron star. A neutron in retirement, so to speak. This means that the magnetars we see in our galaxy today are only a few that have ever existed. It is estimated that there might be as many as 30 million inactive magnetars in the Milky Way alone. While they are still dense and still magnetic, they are just not so deadly. Let's just stay out of the way of magnetars, active or retired. What do you guys say? And while we are talking about strange cosmic things, let's talk about the cosmic nomads, the mysterious rogue planets. Astronomers, scientists, and common folk like us can spend decades debating the status of objects in our solar system. Is little Pluto a planet? What will become of Saturn now that it's losing its rings? Well, the truth is, every planet in every solar system got the short end of the stick. The winners of the cosmic game are the nomads, the wanderers, the rogue planets. Our galaxy is full of stars and planets. Typically, there is at least one star per planet, wherein the planet orbits around that star. The Milky Way has a few hundred billion stars, giving us therefore a few hundred billion planets orbiting those stars. And for every planet, there is at least one rogue planet, marking its journey in space. So, what is a rogue planet? Rogue planets are cosmic objects that move freely, unattached and single in space. They do not orbit any particular star, and have masses very similar to the planets in our solar system. By virtue of their small size and dim light, they are extremely hard to detect. They only glow weakly in the infrared from any internal heat they may have. More reasons for them to be called rogues. And more reasons for them to have remained undetected, and a mystery for astronomers. Well, until now. In a stunning discovery, on December 22, 2021, a team of astronomers discovered at least 70 new rogue planets in our galaxy. Under normal circumstances, a planet not in proximity to its parent star would have no source of illumination, and hence difficult to detect. But these planets were glowing, and hence identifiable. Using data from several European Southern Observatory, ESO, telescopes, and other facilities spanning 20 years, astronomers and scientists took advantage of the fact that, in the few million years after their formation, these relatively young planets were still hot and glowing, allowing them to be discovered by sensitive cameras on large telescopes. The team measured tiny motions, colors, and luminosities of millions of sources in a large section of the space, the Upper Scorpius. They measured the points of light in optical and near-infrared wavelengths and combined the measurements with the movement they detected. This allowed them to identify the faintest objects in the sky, the rogue planets. They found that many of the planets have masses comparable to Jupiter's in a star-forming region close to our Sun, located within the Scorpius and Ophiuchus constellations. This region of sky lies 420 light years away from Earth. The detection of so many rogue planets also begs the question, how did these rogue planets come to be? By studying the newly found rogue planets, astronomers are trying to find clues to this mystery. Some scientists believe rogue planets were formed from the collapse of a gas cloud that was too small to form of a star. Others believe that they may have been kicked out from a solar system similar to ours. If this is true, then the possibility of there being a host of Earth-sized rogue planets journeying through the cosmos is very high. This discovery of 70 rogue planets has been a monumental step in allowing us to better understand the origins of these elusive cosmic nomads. For example, we have the OTS-44, a potential rogue planet, 11 times the mass of Jupiter, and 554 light-years away. The debate on whether it is a rogue planet, or an object known as the brown dwarf, is still on. On the other hand, the Obel 2019 BLG0551, although is the size of Earth, could either be a rogue or a regular planet, on an extremely wide orbit from its parent star. However, what has excited astronomers and scientists the most, is the speculation of rogue planets harboring life. We have seen that although the rogue planets are neither illuminated nor warmed by stars, they do have internal heat. And where there is heat, there is likelihood of water. Which is what we need to live and harbor life. Fancy a trip to a rogue planet? According to statistics, humans are most likely not alone in the universe. Fermi's paradox can help us think about this possibility. Alien civilizations may have already arisen, prospered, and become interplanetary, given the abundance of stars expected to have planets like Earth, where liquid water, life, and a moderate atmosphere support life. Aliens may find traveling to other universes as simple as going from home to the nearest McDonald's. If this is the case, we may not need to colonize faraway worlds in order to meet them. They might make an attempt to contact us. It's both terrifying and intriguing to consider But how will aliens communicate with humanity? What would be the most effective manner for a technologically advanced alien civilization to announce its arrival throughout the galaxy? It could be to make its star system's planets dance in a mathematical sequence. Many searches for intelligent life have been carried out thus far, such as probing for radio signals or megastructures around stars, but the results have been vague and have natural explanations. That's why a scientist from France has proposed that we hunt for planets orbiting in precise patterns that could only have evolved purposefully. Their hypothesis is that a highly evolved civilization could alter the orbits of planets in its solar system to serve as a beacon of its presence to an observer from the outside. The gravitational pull of asteroids might be used to slowly move planets into new places over thousands of years, causing them to have full orbits, relative to one another, in a specific fixed ratio, or resonance. Natural gravitational interactions produce such resonances. For example, Jupiter's moon Io completes 4 Jupiter orbits for every 2 Europa orbits and 1 Ganymede orbit, forming a 2-to-1 resonance chain. Similar patterns have been observed in other star systems, although those in which the ratios of each body differ, rather than creating chains, have never been observed. As a result, the researchers believe aliens may organize their planets in sequences that are unlikely to occur naturally, such as a prime number series, or the Fibonacci sequence. The researchers calculated that these orbits may persist for 20 billion years before losing resonance, even surviving the demise of their host star. The concept is similar to colossal structures on Earth, such as ancient Egypt's tallest pyramids, which were built to last beyond the lifetime of a civilization. Similarly, this beacon has the potential to outlast its creators. Even if we did uncover such a sequence, it wouldn't prove intelligent life, and it's possible that the civilization behind it has long since vanished. But the relics of it might still be found. What do you guys think?